Okay, so I'm going to flute a jug, beat a jug. Start off by marking in some lines. When fluting, I like to put two lines in because the cut of the fluting usually hits one of them. Makes it a bit unclear. If you have two lines, leave the second line with a nice border. I'm going to do something on the rim, so this line on the inside also forms a bit of a frame. Sort of pie crust pastry decoration. This is a very worn down fluting tool, a bit of Watt spring originally. Now, one of the nice things about fluting a shape with a handle on is that you don't have to match up the lines exactly all the way around because the handle forms a very natural break. So, I start off doing a corner. Just fill in that corner first. Here I'm trying to drop down parallel to the handle. And each time I'm trying to hit the top line with the bottom edge of the tool without trying too hard. Basically, trying to make the same movement of the tool and the pot each time, because the pot is got a rounded belly. It means that here the lines have to be a little bit more spaced out, here and here a little bit more bunched up. It's a good idea not to worry too much while you're going round what it's going to look like. It'll probably look a lot better when you finish the whole thing. This decoration, for me, is a tribute to David Leitch, Bernard Leitch, his father. Also, all seems to be a little bit Greek. Almost like a stone carving decoration, something you might see on a pillar. So here we've joined up with where we started. Now the last bit is to fill in the top. Holding the tool quite loosely, sharp enough to cut it by itself. the tampon. Which is really just another decorative element. There you go. Good luck.